Hi guys. So, as some of you may know, I did mention that I was going to be making a video about the current Melanie Martinez stuff. Just a disclaimer, I personally do have an opinion on whose side I'm taking, but I'm not going to state it in this video for my own privacy and just so I don't get a lot of controversy like I'm probably going to get from making this video. But I do not have a lot of evidence of what was happening since I do not have TikTok or Twitter. That's where most of this took place, but I will be linking a video where a very amazing YouTuber made a huge video about this. I'm just gonna state what's been going on that I know of. So around 2017, when Melanie Martinez was starting her Crybaby tour, I believe, Timothy Heller, and if you don't know who Timothy Heller is, apparently she was one of Melanie Martinez's best friends, but and Timothy Heller was also a music artist alongside Melanie Martinez. Now, they didn't make any songs together, but they were friends. Well, around Crybaby Tour, when Melanie Martinez was gaining more popularity, Timothy Heller came out with certain allegations I cannot say due to YouTube. So I will just say it has to do with, it's something I cannot say on YouTube due to its censorship or whatever. But I will state what it is in my pinned comment. But Timothy Heller came out with these allegations, and she made this whole story out about how Melanie Martinez did it to her during a sleepover. And Melanie didn't reply to this for the longest time, and apparently Crybaby fans were going after Timothy, sending threats, just leaking her address and stuff like that, which, no matter whose side you are on, Melanie or Timothy's, you have to agree that is not okay at all. Any circumstances, I don't care how horrible a person you are, that is not okay. But then people were going after Timothy because her story didn't make sense. And I do agree, after reading her story, it didn't make sense because she said that the sleepover where it happened took place when Melanie was on tour. And just so you know, when Melanie is on tour, she can't do much because apparently she was not in the state where Timothy was when it happened. Well, after a while, Melanie did reply to it. I don't have the full screenshot. Like I said, the person who made an amazing video about this will be given credit, and it will be posted in the description and possibly link comment if it lets me. But basically, Melanie's reply was she did not say no to things we chose to do together. And a lot of people take this out of context, and when this is taken out of context, people think this was Melanie Martinez's way of saying, "Oh, she never said no, so I thought it was okay." No, when you read her actual thing coming out talking about it, it makes a lot more sense. So please, if you were ever trying to explain this, do not take that out of context. And just so you know, she did not say she never said no to what we do together. No, she said she never said no to what we chose to do together, I believe. I don't know if that's word for word, but I know it's in there somewhere. Again, I will link it. And then, as years go by, now that Melanie is a lot bigger because of Portals and K through 12, and she just released her, and she's on Trilogy Tour. Well, Timothy has come back up on TikTok, which, by the way, Timothy left social media for the longest time due to the hate she was getting. And so I thought it was a little weird how Timothy came back up to talk about it, but that's just my personal opinion, especially that she came up and talked about it in the middle of a tour. But again, that's just my opinion. And then as this was going on, she came out and made a new story. Personally, like I said, I haven't really read into it due to I don't have TikTok and I don't have Twitter. Why would I want those apps? So I don't really know. Like I said, I'll link a video with more information. And so a lot of Melanie Martinez's people are destroying her merch like they did way back in 2017. And they are destroying it, ruining it, instead of selling it. Like, I personally think selling it would be a lot more better. But that's just me. And so a lot of crybabies are on Timothy Heller's side, which personally, that's okay. Believe whoever you want. Just if you're in the wrong afterwards, apologize. That's my personal opinion. Don't do it if you don't want to. But yeah, that's all I really know so far. And Melanie hasn't made a public statement about this, and she probably won't since she is still on tour. She is way too busy to be replying to stuff like this. I forgot to mention that back in 2017, Melanie did release a song about it, which is called Piggyback. It is not unreleased. It's on SoundCloud. She just didn't really post about it a lot because Timothy took it as a diss track. It wasn't. It was just explaining her side of the story. And there are some lyrics in there that I think you guys should listen to and bring into accountability. But again, this is all that's happening. I won't be saying which side I'm on. But if you can put up the pieces, I'm pretty sure you can figure out whose side it's on. No matter what's going on, if you believe Timothy Heller, please don't go on Melanie Martinez's videos about her, videos where people mention her and say, oh, well, she's a bad person, you shouldn't listen to her or whatever. Please don't do that. That's the equivalent of you, I don't really know what it's the equivalent of, but just please don't do that. You wouldn't like it if Melanie Martinez's fans did that to you. So just please don't do it. And most people don't know about this since their whole life doesn't revolve around drama. So whatever you do, whoever side you're on, please don't bring this up on videos. That's not relevant about it. Okay. Thank you guys so much for listening. Goodbye.